नमस्ते सदा वत्सले मातृभूमि। इट इज टाइम फॉर पेट्रियट्स टू रिजॉइस एंड इट इज सैड स्टोरी फॉर द टुकड़े टुकड़े गैंग एंड हेट मोदी ब्रिगेड। इन ए ड्रास्टिक टर्न ऑफ इवेंट्स नेपाल्स सुप्रीम कोर्ट टुडे आस्क्ड its president Bidya Devi Bhandari to appoint Nepali Congress leader Sher Bahadur Duba as the prime minister within 2 days. This comes barely 2 months after Prime Minister KP Oli was able to form a minority government despite losing a trust vote in the House. The court led by Chief Justice Cholendra Shumsher Rana annulled the dissolution of the Parliament by President Bhandari and the continuation of Oli as the Prime Minister till elections are held in November. The question now is, what does it mean to the relationship between India and Nepal, even for a brief period? To remind my viewers, in 2015, Oli became hostile towards India as he suspected the hand of Narendra Modi government to support ethnic Madheshi agitation for more political power in the Tarai region and impose a 5-month fuel blockade from September same year. Oli also suspected that the Modi government had manipulated support from the Nepal Maoists and with NPC support, that is Duba's support, toppled his government in July 2016. During this crisis, Oli turned to China and signed several agreements with Beijing, including for emergency fuel supplies. China also promised to build the $2.5 billion Budhi Gandaki hydropower station. But during his brief rule as Prime Minister from mid-2017 to February 2018, the then Prime Minister Duba had cancelled the hydro project. And after February 2018, Oli once again formed the government and began to strengthen relations with China. In this backdrop, appointment of Duba as the Prime Minister is a good augury for India. Duba is pro-India. He is a very strong advocate of India gaining entry into the UN Permanent Security Council. He is also a strong advocate of India helping Nepal in drafting a strong constitution. In fact, the drafting of the constitution or bringing amendment to the constitution, the second amendment, has been a bone of contention between the Madheshis and the Pahadis in Nepal. Madheshis have castes and ethnicities similar to Bihar and Eastern UP, with frequent intermarriages between families on either side of the border. Madhesh has historically been part of the larger Mithila region, and efforts have been made over time to integrate Madhesh in processes of policy formulation in Nepal. The process had started in 1947 and still it has not seen the end of the tunnel. So it is hoped that Duba will work with Prime Minister Narendra Modi to help draft or bring in the necessary amendments to the Nepal Constitution and solve the Madhesh dilemma. This was not happening because of Oli's presence, who is a communist, who belongs to a communist party. Moreover, Duba wants India to help Nepal in harnessing the knowledge economy, such as information technology, and help it set up a stronger railway system and healthcare. He also wants India to help the country to build the infrastructure of renewable energy. Nepal has fast-flowing rivers and has a potential to generate 1 lakh megawatt of electrical energy, which can be harnessed and exploited. So his appointment will bring Nepal closer to India than China. It is time for patriots to rejoice, and it is a sad story for the Tukde Tukde gang and hate Modi brigade. Jai Hind, Vande Mataram.